I think organic lifestyle is the future.
We decided to go organic because there was a demand for it.
It's a great lifestyle, a great way to raise kids and raise healthy food.
USDA organic standards require that all USDA certified organic livestock must be fed 100% organically grown and prepared feed. This includes pastures and forages, grains, as well as plant materials used as bedding for organic livestock. Certain feed additives such as vitamins and minerals can be fed to organic livestock.
So we're a certified organic farm. So our pasture here has been certified organic, and so all our feed that we get is also organic certified. The way we know whenever we're looking for feed, we make sure that we get an organic food producer certificate from the person that we're getting the food from, so that we know that they are certified, so nothing comes back to us, and make sure that we're feeding them what they should be getting to stay in compliance with the organic certifications.
Organic producers are required to provide diets that are adequate to meet the nutritional requirements of their animals. The USDA organic regulations also require access to pasture for ruminant livestock during the grazing season.
So the pasture rule was written for ruminants. So it specifically is talking about ruminant, but all animals need outdoor access.
The regulations have specific requirements and guidelines for organic ruminant livestock, such as cattle, sheep, and goats. Specifically, these animals must consume at least 30% of their dry matter intake as pasture or residual forage during the grazing season, which must be at least 120 days per year.
In the winter months, we feed silage, haylage, purchased grain, purchased alfalfa, and in the summer months, we graze the animals, and after we take the first cutting, grass off of the 75 acres to put into silage bags. We wait about 30 days and then we have beautiful 2-acre paddocks that we give the cows a feeding of after every milking, and we manage that so my 60 to 100 cows, depending on the time of the year, have access to pasture for a minimum of 20 to 150 days. So, and it just takes a little management, and I have a spreadsheet that I document as they move from pasture to pasture, and when they go out in the spring, and how many days they're out, and how much they consume.
Ruminant livestock producers also are required to document all feed rations fed to each type of livestock, including feed produced on farm, feed purchased from off-farm sources, feed supplements and additives, and pasture provided.
These are our silage bags. They're our feed storage for the winter. They're in siled shortcut grass. They're 1.5 tons per lineal foot, and it's like canning your feed for the winter for the cows. My feed rations do change over the course of the year. I have what we consider a spring-summer ration, which the cows are mainly on pasture. They don't take the stored feed that we keep through the winter months, and I work with a nutritionalist who writes up a plan that I can keep healthy cows.
In order to verify your farm's compliance with the organic standards, your inspector will choose at least one feed type to audit over a period of time. The purpose of a feed audit is to evaluate if producers have enough organic feed produced on farm or purchased to provide for their animals' needs over the course of the year.
When tracking your feed, you have to show that you've had enough feed on farm to produce how much eggs that you say you're producing. Otherwise, they might think there's a discrepancy that maybe you're sourcing feed from somewhere else that's not organic. Other things too, that if you go in the coop, you can see we have our nesting boxes, and the nesting box is straw, so the eggs are protected when they're laid, they don't get cracked. You need to also source organic straw for your nesting boxes, because the chickens can eat that if they choose, and so that has to be organic.
In addition to the records of how much feed they grew and purchased, we would ask to see records during a feed audit for how much feed has been used. This is an area that we get a lot of questions from our customers about. What we need to do a successful feed audit is for the amount that is actually being fed to get recorded at least every time it changes. And that way we can piece together how much feed has been used for each group of animals.
An audit trail refers to the documentation necessary to determine the source, movement, and transfer of ownership of any organic product. A complete audit trail tracks the identity, sources, and quantities of every feed ingredient back to the source.
For producers that grow their own feed, one of the things that's most important to remember is to keep a record of the harvest and yield of their own crops. Sometimes that's forgotten because producers think that since they're not selling it, it might not have a record involved. But in order to do a feed audit, we're going to need to know how much organic feed they produced. For producers that are buying feed, keeping the invoices and receipts and making sure that they identify the feed as organic is an important way to prepare for the feed audit.
Just keeping your records organized, even if it's just in manila folders, is going to make your inspection go so much faster than if things aren't in chronological order. I need to sort them into piles from what they are. And so just those little steps can make an inspection go so much faster than if I'm sitting there sorting and trying to guess where these records go.
The USDA National Organic Program's Guide for Organic Livestock Producers provides a list of records needed to show compliance with the organic regulations.
So we keep all of our records in QuickBooks and Excel, and that makes our organic inspection really easy every year. I've got all of the records right at hand and then a folder with all of the receipts, so it makes it really easy for the inspector and I to sit down and look at how much I've spent on feed, what kind of feed I've gotten, and then how many birds I have on hand.
Additional records must be kept for ruminant livestock, including grazing records that include pasturing dates and locations, a method for calculating dry matter demand, and dry matter intake for feeds and pasture.
When my inspector comes out for an audit, she or he looks through my documentation to see when the feed has been purchased, when the animal has been fed. Do I have enough feed to cover my animals through the winter season? Do I have enough pasture in the fields? They look at the fields to see if I have able to pasture the minimum 120 days of 30% dry matter intake is very important. So I try to do better than that.
A producer's feed rations may be updated at any time if they turn out to be different than expected. Careful documentation of your changes will allow the inspector to understand your operations practices and verify compliance with the organic standards.
Whenever we change the amount of feed that we feed the chickens, we write it down in an Excel spreadsheet where I'm also keeping track of the number of birds that we have so that we can compare the number of birds that we have versus how much feed that we are feeding them so that we know when to order more feed and make sure that the birds are staying healthy.
People say that the organic certification it's hard, it's a lot of paperwork, it takes time, and it can take time, and the paperwork, honestly, it's not as hard as people think it is. It's pretty doable, and the renewal packet's pretty simple. If nothing's changed, it's pretty easy to go through it pretty quickly. People that come out to do the inspections and things like that are pretty awesome, pretty easy to get along with and look at stuff, and they're not out to make you to be a bad guy or anything like that. They want to help you, and they want to make the process as easy as it can be.
For more information about organic livestock certification, please visit these websites.